Which one do you think is more efficient, magnetic gears or conventional mechanical gears? Previously, using this electromagnetic brake, I found the efficiency of mechanical gears, specifically these 3D printed herringbone gears, to be around 85%. I then tested this radial flux magnetic gearbox, which is a non-contact, lubrication-free, no-wear gearbox, so the first shooting is that it would be more efficient. However, surprisingly, it turned out to be around 55%, which for some reason I couldn't trust this result, so I made this axial flux magnetic gearbox. And now, it's time for another efficiency test. So currently, the power on the input shaft is 5.3 watts and the output is around 4.3 watts. The magnetic gearbox in between caused a power loss of 1 watt and right now, it's running at around 80% efficiency. Fortunately, it didn't turn out as low as the previous one. By the way, this result was achieved with the flux modulator using steel inserts in the metal segments. There's also a modulator where I used transformer core pieces instead of steel inserts, and you can see the difference in their effect on the torque capacity. In the previous video, thanks to the improved modulator, the gearbox's torque capacity increased by 60%. So does this improved modulator also increase the efficiency? But it seems like the new modulator doesn't have a significant effect on the efficiency, as the efficiency only slightly increased to 81.5%, which is almost the same as the 3D printed mechanical gears and about 25% more than the previous radial flux one. And I believe that this value can be further increased with the thrust bearings and metal parts. And also, the low efficiency of radial flux one might be due to the low applied load. So I also tested this gearbox under variable loads to see this clearly, and the results proved what I was saying. Indeed, at low loads, the efficiency was quite low, around the same as the radial one. However, as the load increased, it operated more efficiently, just like mechanical gears. But of course, an increase in load also means an increase in eddy currents in the metal segments, which would typically result in the gearbox heating up. However, when I opened it up, the gearbox wasn't warm at all. Magnets, metal segments were all cold. This is obviously a bit unusual despite the gearbox running under load, so I tested it again under the same speed and load, but this time against time. The gearbox ran for 8 minutes, and surprisingly, once again, nothing warmed up, and the efficiency didn't decrease at all during the test, around 80%. Then thinking that there wouldn't be any heating due to these core pieces, I also tried it with the other modulator, but again there was no heating. By the way, to measure the efficiency, I compared the mechanical powers on the input and output shafts. For the power on the input shaft, I have the motor mounted freely, and I measure the torque using a load cell and the speed with a Hall sensor to calculate the mechanical power. And for braking, I run the motor in the opposite direction. This method allows to apply a load on the output shaft while also being able to measure this load from the motor body. In the end, I can say that the efficiency of magnetic and mechanical gears is almost the same. And even if it was lower, it wouldn't be a problem because magnetic gears have a significant advantages such as much quieter, lubrication-free or non-contact operation. And as a result of this torque test, the force is around 700 grams and considering the torque arm, the maximum torque that the magnets can transmit without slipping is nearly 0.2 Nm. Yes, as it is now, the torque capacity cannot even be compared to mechanical gears. But since the efficiency is also now promising, the next step is to maximize the torque capacity. Thanks for watching. If you liked it, please subscribe and check out my other videos.